Hello, hello, mic test. Hello guys, I'm Ritvik Dashora and I'm back with a new video and some new learnings. If you're interested to know how to get most recent news of any company in Python for free, then you're at the right place. Today we will use polygon.io to build a Python model which will output a list of all most recent stock news. It can be used for various purposes like making a newsletter, doing sentiment analysis, or just having a track of all your favorite stocks. And you also know this, there can be a million applications for this. Before we start building the model, if you are new around here, on this channel I turn you into a successful financial programmer. Here I upload videos on topics such as making a trading board, talking about some highly valuable finance APIs, implementation of AI in finance, etc, etc. So if there's something you're interested in, then smash on the subscribe button and hit on the bell icon. Also, I offer an amazing gift to all my lovely subscribers. You'll get to know about this in this video itself. So without spending any more time, let's start. So the topics that we'll cover today is we'll talk about what is polygon.io, then we'll see how to get a free API of polygon.io. We'll construct the API URL, then we'll use the request library to get the most recent stock news. And also, this is a playlist and there are many upcoming videos which will be related to the polygon.io package, and these videos are the first one is the most recent stock news, which is this video itself. The second one will be finding comparable companies which can be used for investment banking purposes, getting company financials. You already know that I have covered a lot of videos related to extracting financial details. You can click on this I button to know more. I have covered videos such as Alpha Vantage, IEX Cloud, 12 Data, Bloomberg, etc. Then we'll talk about stock split, stock dividend information. This will be the fourth video. And the fifth video, which is the last video, will make a screener, a basic screener of top gainers and top losers using the same polygon.io. This is the website of polygon.io. The link is in the description box, and you can see that we can use it to extract financial information. It gives information about the stocks, the forex, crypto, and more. Unfortunately, most of the information is covered under a paid version, which is a paid subscription. In this video, I'll talk about all the free version of polygon.io, and I would say the free version is also a lot useful for everyone. In order to get a free access of a free API of polygon.io, you just need to click here, which is get your free API, and just sign up. After signing up, this window will come, and then we will just go here, which is RESTful docs and WebSocket docs. If you remember, I've already covered a video on WebSocket client. Just to give you a brief idea, WebSocket is a two-way communication system where we can not only just get information from a server but also can provide some information to that particular server, and it can be used to get a real-time streaming data. And I have covered this video to get a real-time Bitcoin data or any cryptocurrency data. You can click on this I button to watch that video. As far as Polygon is considered, all the streaming data, or I would say all the WebSocket information, is paid version. They have actually made it like a blue dot for a paid version and a green dot for a free version. So all these topics are blue dots, so everything is for the paid version. If I get more money on Patreon, maybe in future I will buy this subscription, which is actually quite expensive, and maybe in future I'll cover that video. But if you consider this one, which is the first documentation, which is the RESTful docs, you can see that almost everything is for free, and this is what we will discuss today. There are some APIs which are actually paid, but we can see that most of these are green dots. So yeah, we will cover all these things in my upcoming videos. So after creating an account, you can see that there's API keys on the left. After clicking here, you can see that this is the API key that we'll use in my video. We can just copy it by clicking it here. And also, if you go to edit here, edit option, we can regenerate the API, which I will do after recording this video for sure, because I want you guys to use your own APIs. So I'll be using this API key to make this video. So let's dig into the documentation here. In this video, I am using this ticker news functionality of polygon.io, and you can see that in the end there is a URL which is available to me. If I click on this run query, we can see that a lot of information about about this particular ticker is available to us. And if we go here, this description is the most important thing which we will be using for making this video, because this is the actual news that we are interested in. Let me just close this tab, and the ticker in this case was Apple. So let me just do one thing. Let me just copy this and come here and paste it like this. API URL is equal to this link. In order to get information from this link, I'll have to import requests, and let's make this URL a bit more user friendly. So I have introduced an F string here. API is equal to, there would be an API, this is my API, and let me just paste here like this and convert it into an F string like API. Similarly, ticker is equal to AAPL, and in this case I'll just convert into ticker. What else can I do? Limit. So limit is equal to, it should be in string format, 10, and again here I'll just convert it to limit. Now what is limit? Limit is the total number of news that we are extracting. We can extract n number of news. I don't know the exact maximum limit for this, but I have tried it for 1000 and it worked. So in this case, let me just do it 100. What else can we do? News, we'll have to provide a date. This is the date, and which will be considered as the starting point for any particular news. So for example, if I provide a date, say 5th of April, so I'll get all the recent news after 5th of April. So it should be in year is equal to 2021, month is April, which is 4, day is equal to say 5th of April, and what I have to do here is I have to convert it like this, month to like this, and then last 26, which is a day, to be like this. Perfect. So now let's run this code and let me see what is the API URL now. That's great. If I copy this and then paste it here, after pasting it here, we can see that all the news related to Apple is in front of me. Perfect. So I'll just use the same here. I'll use the requests library to extract all this information in Python. So data is equal to requests.get and then api url.json. Let's see what is the data. So we have got a lot of information, and I would say most of them are irrelevant to us. Let me go to the top and let's see. So we've got count of 100, which is actually 100 news, the URL of that, sorry, this is the next URL, request, and then results. This is the most important thing, and this is the URL of the article. Again, I'm not interested in this. I'm only interested in the description, this one. So let me just write results here. Okay, perfect. So after running this, if I check the zeroth item, you can see that we've got the URL of the article, and then author, description, ID, image URL. If I click it here, okay, this is the image that is used in that article. We are not interested in this. The keywords which are used, the tickers that are used in the article, that are mentioned in the article, that's it. So I'm actually only interested in this description. So if I write description here, I will get the first news which is related to Apple, and if I just say change it to MSFT Microsoft and run all these cells, you'll get the first news related to Microsoft as well. Now I think this is the same news, because polygon.io consider this news to be important for both Microsoft and Apple. Maybe both the tickers are mentioned in this article. Anyways, in order to create a list of all the news, I'll have to make an empty list, which is list1 is equal to an empty list, and then for I in range limit. So I'm considering all the headlines, which are actually total number of headlines are 100, and because it's in string format, I'll have to convert it into an integer format, int. Then we can just write news is equal to, copy and then paste this and change it to I, and then list1 dot append news. That's it. Let me just write one more thing, which is try this. If it does not work, then accept pass. So let's run this cell, and if I write list1, and that's it. We have got a list of all the news which is related to Microsoft. You can see that the Gates family owns 242,000 acres of farmland. Investors are not fully pricing in Microsoft's full potential. Microsoft is growing its EPS, etc., etc. I'm not going to read all the news for you. We have made a list of all the 100 news. Now wait, before you leave, this code will be saved on my Google Drive, and not just this one, there are many more codes that are saved my codes on trading bots, my codes on free finance APIs, etc. And in order to get a free access of my Google Drive, what you need to do is just to subscribe to my YouTube channel and then click on access to my Google Drive button. Just follow some steps over there, provide some details, and I'll be using this email address to provide a free access of my Google Drive. This service is only available to my subscribers and the people who have followed all the steps, and everything is for free for use. And I bet you that you'll find a lot of information over there which you will not find anywhere else. If you like this educational video, then you can support me on Patreon. The link is in the description box. On Patreon, you can see that there are different benefits for different levels. There are 6 levels over there. And for all the different levels, you can see there are different things that I do on Patreon. Your contribution means a lot to me as it keeps me motivated to work harder. I have many plans for this YouTube channel, and for all this, I need your support. And actually, it will be very beneficial for me in future because for some services, I need to pay some fee to get a premium access of some APIs or some softwares, which I'll cover in future. I'm telling you, I won't disappoint you. You've just seen the trailer. The movie is yet to come. The Patreon link is in the description box. Thank you so much for watching this video till the end. You can click here to subscribe. And over there, you can see how I used WebSocket client to extract real-time Bitcoin prices in Python. And over there, you can see how I created a Bitcoin trading bot, which actually generated some excess return and has a higher Sharpe ratio than Bitcoin. Like this video, don't forget to subscribe and comment your opinion how you like this video. Thank you so much. See you in the next video. Thank you.